Hello Techie, welcome back to my YouTube channel Tech Solution. I want to teach you the Python as the faster way as possible and more practical way. Now before we get started, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on the notification by clicking on the bell icon. Before going to start, I want to thank you all to your love and support. Now today I am going to cover the most important topic in the Python or any programming language, classes and object. Okay? Python is an object-oriented programming language. Almost everything in the Python is an object with its properties and methods. A classes is like an object constructor or a blueprint for creating object. Okay. Today we are going to cover class and objects. Okay. First topic, create a class. Okay, to create a class we use the keyword class. Okay, every class we have some specified name. It's like a class, my class, colon, enter, and then s equal to 5. It's like a properties of the class. Okay, this is we are going to define a class. This class, my class, have property x that is set to 5. Okay. Now we are going to define a class. Now we are going to create an object. Okay. To create an object, we use the class name my class to create object. Okay. Now class is defined. Now the second thing, create a object. To create object we have to use the class name. It's like a p1 equal to my class. Okay, now if you're going to print p1, then it will print the address of the p1. Okay, my class object has this address. Now we are going to access this value. How we are going to access this value? Using dot and using the variable or property that is inside the my class. Okay. Now if you are going to dot x, then what will happen? It will print 5. Let's run it. Okay. Now this is clear now. Now we'll go with another example that will show you how we are going to define class and all those things. Let's remove this one. A class object support two kind of operation. First is attribute difference and second one initiation. Okay. Now we are going to show you attribute reference. Same class. My class. Okay. And just like I equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we can this is properties, and we can define a method inside a class also. Self return hello world. Okay, this is attribute reference. That is clear now. Now we are going to init class initiation, same like the previous example, like a my class. Okay, set the value of c1. Now it's the same. If you are going to print c1, then what it will print? It will print the memory address of c1. Okay, my class object is this one. Now if you are going to access the value of i, we can use dot i. Now if you are going to run, then it will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Now if you are going to access this method, this is basically nothing but as a method of my class. Okay? Now how you are going to access? If you are going to dot f, then it will give you the memory of this methods. Okay? Let's run it. Right? My class object. Add this one, right? Bound method my class. Okay, f my class data. This object at this one. This is the address of class F. Now if you are going to access and return this value, what we have to do? We have to use the parenthesis, because in the class F, in the definition F, right, we don't have anything other than self. I will tell you about what is self. Okay, now if you are going to run, then it will print hello world. Okay, that is clear. Now if you are going to just like a dot x, okay, and plus x, okay, now if you are going to pass Python, okay, then what it will print? It will print hello world Python. Okay, this return. Okay, hello world Python. Give the space here, runs once again. Right. Okay, hello world Python. This is clear now. Now we are going to give you the another example, another function, init function. That is very important function. Okay, in this example that I show you, the last two example, that is classes and objects in the simplest form and are not really useful in the real life application. To understand the meaning of classes, we have to understand the built-in init function. Double underscore init double underscore. Okay, this is init function with parenthesis. All classes have a function called init, okay, which is always executed when the class is being initiated. Use the init function to assign values to object properties or other operations that are necessary to do when the object is being created. Okay, I will explain what is init. Third one, init function. Okay, now I'm going to create a class person. Okay, colon enter. Now I am going to define init. If you heard about any other programming language, that is default constructor. Okay, the same like init here. Name is. Okay, enter. Now self dot name equal to name. Set dot age equal to age. Okay, the init is defined. Now we are going to call this class person. How we are going to call? The same way. Okay, p1 equal to person. But what the parameter will be there? We have two parameter, name and age. If I am not going to pass the two parameter, then it will give the error. Let's run it. Right, he is saying init missing two argument, positional argument, name and age. Then we have to pass the parameter name and age. Jones, no. 55. Okay. Now if you are going to run, it will work fine. It will not give any error, right? Now how we are going to access this name and age? For that we have to print p1 dot name. Or for it, print p1 dot age. Okay. Now let's run it. Okay, John Cena and 45. This is clear now. Okay, basically the init function is called automatically every time the class is being used to create an object. Okay, in the last two exam what I saw, basically when you don't pass anything, what will happen? It will create by default was the or the person class, it will create an object. But here what will happen, because we are using init, then we have to use the same way. If you don't have to pass anything here, just like when I go, okay, let's go with new example, class same person, and then default init, and don't pass anything, print equal to 5. Okay, that's it. Now if you are going to p1 equal to person, what will happen here? Because see here, now we are not passing any variable, right? Yeah, any input parameter other than self, then we will not give any error. Let's run it and see. Right, we will not give any when the Let's go with another example. Object method. Fourth one. Object method. Okay. What the object method will do? Objects can also contain methods, and methods in object are functions that belongs to the object. Let's create a method in the person class. Okay. Let's use the example class person and define init, pass the age and name. Okay. And self dot age equal to age, self dot name equal to name. Okay, now define one method. This is basically the class of the method. Okay, this is basically default constructor, right? Init. Now if I am going to define one method, it's like a myfunc self. Okay, now print hello, my name is plus self dot name. Okay, now I'm going to initiate an object p1 equal to person. Okay, and then passing the value John Shino 45. Okay, now if you want to access the value of name, this function, what we have to do, we have to call p1 dot method name my func. Okay, and let's run it. What will print? Basically in this we are going to initiate the age and name. Okay, and when you are going to call this one p1 dot my function, what it will do, it will print hello, my name is John. And if you are going to add age also, then no problem, you use self dot age. Okay, then it will print hello, my name is John Sino, age 45. Okay, is 45. Let's run it. Okay, hello, my name is 45 name. Okay, and okay, this is reverse, that's why this age it will come first, otherwise like that. Okay, let's run one again. Hello, my name is John Sino and age 45. For that you can give the space also between age, and let's run again to make it clear. Hello, my name is John Sino, age 45. Okay, this is clear now. Now we basically, the shape parameter is a reference to the current instance of the class and is used to access variable that belongs to that class only. Okay, let's go with another example. Shape parameter. Shape parameter is a reference to the current instance of a class and is used to access variable that belongs to that class. It doesn't have to name self. You can call it whatever you like, but it has to be the first parameter of any function in the class. Okay, in the last example, basically what I saw, self, right? You can use any name whatever you want. Last person, enter, define init, right? In self, you are using any name that you want. Okay, just like a my silly object. Okay, comma name, comma age, my silly object dot name equal to name. Okay, in my silly object dot age equal to age. Okay, define. Now we're going to define a function, my func. Okay, abc. Okay, and print hello, my name is abc dot name. Okay, same example we're using, but we are not using self, we are using the different name. Now we are going to initiate a person. Okay, enter. Now I am going to call the method of a class person, p1.myfunc. Okay, name you can add just like a last example, and age, okay, and then abc.age, okay, and then for that you can pass John Chino name and age 45. Now let's run it. Then what will print? First it will set it. This will call this constructor. Okay. And it will set name John Cena and age 45. Okay. Now I'm going to call this one p1.myfunc. This will call this method or function. Okay. And then it will print, hello, my name is John Cena and age is 45. Let's run it. It's missing one required additional argument to be here because comma is missing here. Okay, now runs once again, right? Hello, my name is John Cena. You can put the space and run once again, and age is 45. Okay, now this is clear. Now we are going to, how we are going to modify object properties. You can modify object properties on object like this. I will show you how we are going to modify an object properties. Now P1 age is 45, right? Now if you are going to, okay, now age is, we are going to set 40. Then what we have to do? We have to use P1.age equal to 40. Okay. Now we are going to run it. Then what will print? It will print, hello, my name is John Cena and the age is 40. Okay. Let's run it. We have to pass a string here, age is 40. Okay, let's run it. Okay, hello, my name is John Cena and age is 40. Okay, this is clear. Now we are going to show how you are going to delete object properties. For deleting the object properties, we have to use delete. I will show you del keyword, del p1.age. okay, you have to use after that. Okay, then what will happen? This object properties that is set created here, right? When you are going to create an instance on object, then what will happen is going to create a class of an object and will access a memory, right? In the memory, basically it will give you name and age. Okay, now if you are going to delete p1.age, what will happen? It will delete the age, and only in the person class, that will be name only. Let's run it. Okay, it will not give anything, but if you are going to access p1.age, then it will give you error because using del keyword we have deleting the object property. Let's run. Right, person object has no attribute age, but we can access name because name we still there. Let's run it. Then it will not give any error, it will print John Cena. Okay, this is clear, this is very important. Okay, now we are going to do final one, pass statement. Pass statement, nothing, a class definition cannot be empty, as you know, right? But if you have, for some reason, have class definition with no content, put in the pass statement. With one delete object. Now 6 month pass statement. Okay, now just remove everything. And if you are creating a class, my class, okay, and it will not give anything, then it will give you error. Okay, syntax error, unexpected end of file while passing. Now if you don't want to put anything and still want to create a class, use the pass statement. Okay, then it will not give any error, right? This is clear. For today, that's it. Thank you so much for watching my video. I am going to post more and more video on daily basis. So if you want to watch my video in future, just subscribe in below bell icon with all. He will notify you when my new video will come. and please don't forget to like and share. We will meet once again in new video with new topic. Thank you.